Sunnah is the non-recited type of revelation that comes from the practices in the life of the Messenger, peace be upon him. Unfortunately, nowadays, there's a marginal tendency to downplay the importance of Sunnah in our lives as Muslims. Welcome to Foundation 33. First of all, the Quran is not enough for us to fully understand our religion comprehensively and live it. Let me give you two examples. First, the Quran tells us to perform Hajj. However, the Prophet, he showed us how to do it and we are following his example. There are many detailed rituals that need to be performed for Hajj, and some of them are not explained fully in the Quran. Second, let's talk about Salah, aka prayer. Again, the Quran tells us to perform the obligatory, aka fard prayers, but it does not tell us how we should pray. We learn how to pray from the Prophet through Sunnah. How else would we know when to pray and when to recite Quran during Salah, how long the rakat should be, etc. The Quran concisely orders us what to do, but oftentimes we have to look at the Sunnah to figure out how to in detail. So if you ever hear the argument that Sunnah is not important, ask that person, how can you pray Salah or go to Hajj without the Sunnah? How are you gonna know those things? Lastly, someone who believes in the Quran should follow the Sunnah because the Quran literally tells us to do it. Consequently, the Quran is the first and most important source for Muslims. However, without the Sunnah, the Quran is not enough to understand the religion of Islam with all the details. So, the religion of Islam can only be understood with both Quran and the Sunnah together.